Good evening to every Ambazonian all over the world, from the north and the south zone of Ambazonia, and from all the rest of the world and the rest of the countries in Africa. I salute, I throw greetings to you people for the great work you people have been doing to make that this revolution change steps at every level. I throw great salute to the ground forces, to the self-defense groups, which have taken their personal initiatives, you know, to carry the struggle to the level which it is now. But before I start bringing you some light, you know, conversation and hopes, because my name is Mr. Hopes for now, and I would like all Ambazonians to be called Hopes, Mr. Hopes, you know. It's because of hopes Obama had to win the election. He counted too much on hopes. He said all the Americans should have hopes. Then before I start to give you a bit of, you know, live discussion concerning, you know, the struggle and how we are progressing and the successes that is ahead of us and how I see that we are going to be soon in Boya, and to talk a bit also about, you know, my trip to Boya by His Honorable President Sako. I will first of all start with the national anthem.
Okay, I will start, you know,
by giving you that there's great hopes in this struggle. The Ambazonians must achieve their independence. I am assuring you that God came in my dream and told me, we are going to achieve this independence. We are going to achieve this independence. Why? As I can tell you, if the ambassador of the United States can come and visit Yaounde, a terrorist country, he came with a reason. Even though he did not meet the right people, but at least there is a message which has been passed to him, who is carrying back. So, in this life, we are begging the ambassador that when he goes back, let him know and put the information he has got and what he has seen in Ambas land and how the Ambas people are struggling and being killed. They should put it to his president and also try to carry the message to the United Nations. This is a good step. Even though the people who represented us are not rare representatives. Because rare representatives are people like His Honorable Sisoko Ayoktabe, who is still in captivity, who was kidnapped from Nigeria and extradited to the jungle cells in Cameroon. Then we are happy that there's good news that it is doing very well. Because now they have proof that he is there, because we were still doubting. People like the IG and President Sako and leaders of the Revolution Armies, Joe Ayaba, Ebenezer Akwanka, representative of the Revolution Armies in Ground Zero. Those are the people and many others and all the Ambazonians who have to sit on the round table with any person whatsoever in this world before they can talk any business of how to make peace. And the peace is the independence of Cameroon. The independence of Ambazonia as a free country, and Cameroon will also remain as there has been in the past, independent as La Republic, so that now we can be as good, neighbors, and we can do business together, treating together without problem. Because it should be known that, it should be taking note that for quite a long time, for 57 years, the Ambazonians has never done anything to the citizens of the Republic. Nothing bad for them. For the citizens of the Republic. But the government of the Republic has been very, very wicked, cruel to the Ambazonians. Because as I can tell you, our late father suffered in the hands of this dictatorial government of the Republic. We also suffered. It's only now that God has poured manna from heaven to come and free us. So, let me tell you people, God help those who help themselves. Ambazonians have to help themselves. This is the only opportunity we have to free ourselves from slavery. We have been suffering for long. This is the only opportunity. If most we don't have this freedom, we will suffer for the rest of our life. We should put away all the idea of federation. Just throw it away, put it in the deep sea limbo. We should put away the idea of whether it's state or province or what they want to do. Let's just forget about that one. We are Ambazonians, we are English speaking. We are Ambazonians. We want just our independence. And we will fight for the independence we have it. No matter what any country will say, or any country, no matter France, Britain, America, or anything, we are just for independence. We are for independence. Yes. We are for independence. There is nothing again. We struggled for years, for many years, for federation. Federation failed. If you open your mouth, you are arrested, you are beaten, you are put into cell, they disappear you. They come in the night and kidnap you and carry you away. So that is a forgotten alternative. So people who are just talking about, federation, let me just tell that you people are looking for your real death. Because after this killing, it's just the proof that if you fumble after this killing and you say you want another thing, they will massacre everybody. Everybody who is in this struggle will be massacred. Not even just everybody, but they will massacre all the Ambazonians one by one because they have already started. So now we have to struggle. Since we are in self-defense, we have to fight hard. Fight hard and hard, harder and harder, and fight and fight and fight. And we will succeed because God is on our side. Because the land is our land. We are used to the land. We were born there. And nobles were buried in this land, that land. So we know the land. The land respects us. So nobody can come and win us in a fight inside that land. So I'm happy with the Bakosi people that are standing up. I'm happy with the Manu people that are standing up. I'm happy with the people in Bamenda, the people in Kumbo, the people everywhere. Let the people in the city also stand up. Let the people in the city, in Tigo, in Limbe, Boyakumba, all those big cities in Southwest and Northwest, Bamenda, let them stand up then. Yes. You can see, yesterday, there was a serious protest in Yaoundé, which gave me a lot of hopes. There was a serious protest yesterday, the 9th of April, 2018, in Yaoundé. Serious protest. The Francophones stood up and said, no, they should stop causing massacres and killing the Ambazonians. They said they denied it. They don't accept it. They should stop. The government should stop killing. That is wrong. There was serious protest. And some foolish Ambazonians that are there in Limbe, they are whether so-called cultural world, a whole place was polluted with armies. People are in Limbe, they say cultural, they are carrying our cultural world, I don't know. What type of culture are you people dancing and doing it in Limbe when they are burning all their villages? Where the culture has to take place, the red culture which is in the village, all the villages have been born. Then you are celebrating the burning of the village that you are making cultural week in Limbe. This is terrible. Let Ambazonians try to start thinking wiser. They are killing all your people in the villages, all your children that escaped there in Nigeria as refugees. They are burning their villages, they are raping the children, they are killing. Then you are celebrating cultural day, dancing with big traditional dresses. This is real madness. People, a country is in war. You people are dancing. Excuse me. This is really terrible. I was really happy when I realized and saw that in Yaoundé, a serious protest. The Francophone has stand up now, very powerful, said no, you stop the killing of the Ambazonians. That is not right. It's not right that they should stop. Serious protest yesterday, the 9th of April 2018. So that was a good gesture. How can some people leave, you know, leave another nation to cry their own cry, their own die cry, more than the people in Tiko, my people in Tiko, in Motoboronbo, eh? Long Street. No, people in Tiko, Tiko Market. This Ayamba Lawrence talking. How can you people leave? People in, they are protesting there in Yaounde. For your sake, and they are killing Yaounde. You people are there, just enjoy sitting. People in Tiko, people in Limbe. Edina. Buya. People are there in Kumba. They are killing, people are protesting in Yaounde. Francophones are protesting for your own people that are killing. Then you are just there sitting and looking. It's a funny thing. So after everything, perhaps with time, you will come and realize what is going on. Because perhaps some people are still having that. They don't still realize that we are in a revolution, and in a revolution we must win. We must win. So we must have independence. That's why I just brought up this small short video tonight, so that I should really make the people should understand. My people in Tiko, you people should stand up. My people in Mutengene, Cham, you people should all stand up as you have been standing up for long. You people should stand up. My people in Limbe, my 4, my 16, Ekona, Boya, Kumba, Nguti, the stronghold, Lebi Alem, Fosimondi, Akwaya, Kesham, Oyimojok, Ekok, Tali, Urukum, Nkambe, Bamenda, you people should stand up, because Yaounde protested very highly, Francophones protested very highly, and you people will instead be receiving ministers and dancing. Then the other people are protesting for you people, Francophones are protesting. That the genocide should stop. That you should come to a strong negotiation so that we can have our independence. People are protesting for you. Well, let's leave everything to God. Because we know the struggle is God's hand is in the struggle, and we must win. And I know it's because of the move that they saw that now in the east, the defense forces are already entering the east. They say what? That's why they stood up and said, no, this one is becoming. So, congratulations to the different forces, the same different forces. Congratulations. I salute you people. We will do everything to see that we finance my trip to Boya. Okay, let me just give you a small brief reading and small highlight again on the past and a bit of topic about my trip to Boya. In 1961, the terrorists marched their troops and occupied Alam, Ambazonia. Since we had no forces, but only a mobile wing police, we could not stop the aggressor. They went on to dismantle our institutes, cripple our economy, and trying by all means to assimilate us. When our grandparents and parents call for dialogue or freedom of expression, they are beaten, locked up in their cells. So long a time as 56 years, many of them were killed or disappeared. For example, my father passed most of his life before he died, only locked up prison. A person like Fongalafo, always locked up. He's not even locked up that we don't even know whether he's living or not living. That is the life for the struggle. We can see how people are struggling, and some people are sitting quiet and looking. Please, Ambazonians, wake up. God has what it's like to you people to free yourself from slavery. And if you don't do it now, don't blame God, blame yourself. Because God has said this is the time. For it is said there is time for everything in the Bible. Time to be born, time to die. There's time to sleep, time to get up. There's time, you know, to dance, and time to stop dancing. Rain will fall and rain will stop. Sun will shine and sun will set. So this is the time for Amazonians. At first, Amazonians were slaves to the Republic because they occupy our land. But now is the time for them to become independent. So don't give up the fight. Additionally, they are exploiting our resources. We are marginalized. As if this is not enough, they arrest, beat, rape our university students, beat and imprison our lawyers. Finally, they declare war on the Amazonians. We have to fight for self-defense of our fatherland, Ambasland, Ambazonia. My trip to Boya is the only solution. My trip to Boya is the only solution. For now, we have gone so far until now we are at my trip to Boya. Because when the revolution started, it was step by step from BBC Manchu and the others, Kim Terence and the others locked up, and Barrister Agbobala and the other. It changed the step because gradually it was changing and changing. Now we are at my trip to Boya, which is one of the highest step for the independence. Excuse me. Okay, let me throw another light in another domain. What is the essence of being born in a nation? When you are born in a nation, everybody is happy because people hope that you are born to grow up as a youth, be educated by your parents or your relations or relatives, or in some cases, by your government, so that you can be somebody in the society. And by being somebody in the society is being educated and help in the building of the nation and help your families and mankind. If you are born and well educated, and finally you cannot even be given the right to help develop your nation, defend yourself, defend your people, and even the right to freedom of expression, then let me not tell you a lie. You are a missing group of people in the society. You are a missing group of people in the society. And this is what has been happening to the Amazonians for the past 57 years. We're born, being brought up by their parents, working long hours in their farms to send them to school, only to come out with diplomas, big diplomas, degrees, you know, but no job, no right. No job. Some degree holders become Okada riders, some even selling bread, granules, the rest only to sustain life. No right to ask questions. No right to ask for their rights. No right to carry out passive protests, marches in their own country, no right to speak even their own language. And finally, the only end result, if the only end result is that if they dare venture to ask for their rights, they are beaten, student raped, in prison, kidnapped, extradited, villages burned with grandmothers and grandfathers in their houses. People are asked to leave their villages and go to the forest, and killed by helicopter gunshots from the air, and others exiled to Nigeria. This is the work of the dictatorial regime of La République du Cameroun under President Paul Biya, who declared war on us. Let me not tell you a lie. He will fight this war. He will fight. He declared war. He will fight this war. We will not stop the war. We will not stop the war. United Nations comes or it does not come, we will not stop the war. Our luta continua. We will not stop the war till we have independence. We just need independence. He has already declared war. If he thought he will declare war, we will be afraid, he will misjudge himself. He thought that it was in the colonial period, immediately after independence, when he declared war on the Basas and the Bamleke and started killing the Basas. But they were afraid. Us, we are Amazonians. We are not Francophones. We are Anglo-Saxon. We will fight and fight and fight and fight. If we see that we cannot succeed, we will fight and fight and go direct to Buya, direct to Yaoundé, and continue fighting so that we can burn the villages also there in Paul Biya's village. That is what we are aiming to do. But let me tell you people, the Almighty God who have forgive the, let me tell you people, the Almighty God will never forgive the Republic for this massacre being carried out on the Amazonians. Hence, we are going to fight and fight and fight to free our father land, Amazonia. God bless Amazonia. Now, the really new song which we will be singing all time in our mind, even if we are moving, we are sleeping, we have to be singing. All the Amazonians should be singing. Unity, unity, unity. Unity, 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 unity. Finance, 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 finance. My trip to Boya. Unity, unity, unity. Finance, finance, finance. My trip to Boya. Self defense, self defense, self defense now. Self defense, self defense, self defense now. Unity on ground zero, unity in the self-defense forces, unity to protect the refugee in Nigeria, unity to protest in front of the Nigerian embassy to release our leaders, unity to protest in front of the Republic du Cameroun embassy to release all those being held in captivity in the cell of La Republic. Unity in the protests in front of the French embassy all over the world. Unity in protesting in the British embassy all over the world. Unity in protesting in front of the United Nations headquarters in New York. And finally, unity in my trip to Boya. Before I forget, Aluta continua. Prayers on the battlefield. While self-defense by now is doing his good job intensifying at the front a bit, linking La Republic and Amazonia, so that the battle should be on the borders between La Republic and Ambassland. They have burned all our villages. And we have to do the same to them, to their own villages, if it is possible, because they cannot burn our own villages, then their own village is just that they are enjoying. So think about it. Yeah, because that is it, eh? It is even in the Bible. We have been paying bad for bad. We have been paying bad for good. We are so good to the people that have been paying bad always for 56 years of illegal marriage. But now that the Republic has declared war on the Amazonians, we are going to be bad for bad in the name of Jesus Christ. This is in the Bible. That is in Psalms 125, verses 1 to 5. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. That is, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Ambazonia or Boya Mountain or Fako Mountain, which cannot be shaken but endures forever. As a mountain surrounds Jerusalem, as a mountain surrounds Ambazonia, so the Lord surrounds his people both now and forevermore. As the mountain surrounds Ambazonia, so the Lord surrounds all the. As the mountain surrounds Ambasland, so the Lord surrounds all the Ambazonia for now and forevermore. So we are protected by the Lord. The sentence of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous. The scepter of the wicked, the devil, the ghost of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous, because the righteous land for the Ambazonia is Amas land. For the righteous might use their hands to do evil. For the righteous might use their hands to do evil. The scepter of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous. For the righteous might use their hands to do evil. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good, to those who are upright in heart. But those who turn to crooked ways, the Lord will punish with the evildoers. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good. Those Ambazonians, we are good, we do good to them because they are good. But those Ambazonians who turn to cook way, who come behind and join the Republic to cause the massacre, to help to kill, to honor the armies of the occupation, to be killing our citizens, Ambazonians in the forest and everything. They join them with the evildoers, banish them, kill all them. That is the excuse me. That is all these deals who are agents of the Republic. It is in the Bible. I'm reading this is directly from the Bible. That is Psalms 125, verses 1 to 5. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good, but to those who are upright in heart. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good, to those who are upright in heart. But those who turn on crooked ways, the Lord will banish you with the evildoers. Peace be upon Israel. Peace be upon Jerusalem, upon Ambasland. Psalms 124, verses 1 to 8. The song of ascent of David. If the Lord has not been on our side, let Israel say. If the Lord has not been on our side, let Ambazonia say. If the Lord has not been on our side, when men attacked us, when their anger flowed against us, they would have swallowed us alive. the flood would have engulfed us. The torrent would have swept over us. The rushing waters would have swept us away. Praise be the Lord, who had not let us be torn by their teeth. We have escaped like a bird out of the fuller's snare. The snare has broken, and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Psalm 121:29:1-8. They have greatly oppressed me from my youth. They have greatly oppressed me from my youth. Yet Israel, see, they have greatly oppressed me from my youth. Let Ambazonia say, they have greatly oppressed me from my youth, but they have not gained the victory over me. They have oppressed Ambazonia for long. For 57 years, but they have not got the victory over us. They have not got the victory over us. Because the land is blessed. They oppress us and try to carry all the resources, but the resources can never get finished because we are natural gifted, it's still there. That is why they don't want to leave. They don't get control. Now we are going to take back control of our land. They have greatly oppressed me from my youth. Let Israel say, let Abazona say, they have greatly oppressed me from my youth, but they have not gained the victory over me. They suppressed us for long, but they have not gained victory over us. We are now winning. Plowman has plowed my back and make their furrows long, but the Lord is righteous. He has cut me free from the core of the wicked. May all who hate Zion return back in shame. May all who hate Zion return back in shame. All these Jews, all these mayors, who are helping that they should kill our children, causing all the atrocity, you know, massacres everywhere, sending people to the forest, sending refugees, they will turn back in shame. If not, that we should even capture them. May they be like grass on the roof, which wither before it can grow. With it, the reaper cannot feel his arm. May those who pass by them not say, the blessing of the Lord be upon you. We bless you in the name of the Lord. These wicked people, these wicked people, people cannot pass and give them blessings. Oh, you have done a good job for killing Ambazonians. You Ambazonians, you've done a good job for killing Ambazonians. Nobody will give you that type of blessing. Say, you have done a good job. That is what the scripture is saying. Okay, let's come now to a prayer for the day. Prayer for the day, please. It's always very, very necessary to pray. Even if there's what, even on the war front, you have to pray. And always say, thank you, Jesus. Jesus is great. Thank you, Almighty God. Almighty God, you have the Alpha and the Omega. Let us pray. The Almighty and ever-living God, we glorify your name. We give you thanks for providing us with the basic necessity and for providing us with what to eat for today. May you, the Almighty God, bless the food we will eat and the water we will drink. And pour your blessings so that the light of the Holy Spirit should shine everywhere we find ourselves. The Spirit of the Holy Ghost fire should cast down demons and the queen of darkness who are chasing our souls. Should also cast down the occupiers. All occupiers, the army of occupation, cast them down. Let even thunder come out and fire them. Let natural disaster fall on them. They will destroy them. They destroy them in the battlefield as a sort of epidemic. Yes, because you are the God of Abraham. You are the God of Jacob. You are the God of the Amazonia. You are the God of the whole world. You can do and undo. The Almighty God. The Alpha and the Omega. Our destiny lies on your hands. Bless our land. Bless our fathers. Bless our mothers. Bless our children. Bless our neighbors. Bless our relations and destroy our enemies. For you have the powers to do all this. Amen. We will also give praises and thanksgiving to you. For you sacrifice your only begotten Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified on the cross for our sake. Amen. The Lord Almighty is with us. The Lord of Jacob is our fortress. Psalms 47, verse 7. Okay. I will just put you a small music, a small freedom song for the meantime so that you listen, in which you will say something, give you a bit of hopes.
Unity.
Okay, that is a freedom song. We are moving back to Abazunyasu. Join in unity and fight to defend your fatherland. This is the motto for now also. Okay, let me just throw some light before on this topic of vaccination, which we are hearing that in Cameroon here, in Abazunya, they are bringing people to vaccinate people. Parents should take note that this is not the first time that it happened or is happening. This vaccination thing has happened some years ago. I forgot it. Perhaps it's 1985 or so, 1970 something or 80 something. I've forgotten. In Bamenda, when they went to a college and vaccinated people to be sterile. And finally, when the Reverend Father wanted to oppose it, they killed him. I quite remember, I've forgotten the date, but I quite remember my memory. I know that something happened like that. So these people should take care, parents should take care of their children. Because the time of war, they cannot come that they want to vaccinate people. When they are killing the people, then they want to vaccinate them. When they even go right down to the hospitals and take people and go and kill, then they'll come down and vaccinate children in school or what. They will make their child will never put to bed. Because there are so many children who left Bamenda who cannot put to bed now because of the vaccination they did. They carried out some years ago that they even killed the Reverend Father when he was about struggling to protest against. So you people should take note. A stitch in time saves nine. Take note. Okay, I end so far. Thank all the Amazonians for listening and for watching this video. May God bless President Sisiko, who is in the seal. He is testing the seal and knowing also how bitter the seal of our republic is. But this is a blessing because God is with him right inside the seal. May God bless BBC Manchu, Tem Teles, Terence, all the rest who are there in the seals, all for Ghana, for everybody. God bless you people, protect you well, and we hope that one day we will see you people out. Then we march off to Boya to celebrate our independence, celebrate in a great way. Yeah, because now we know, go comrade comes on, we must have the independence. We don't have any other choice. If we don't have the independence, then all of us will be killed. I know. So the only solution for us is independence. There is no option for any other option. There is just no option. No option for independence. Nothing, nothing. Because if it's a separate states or what, it will cause more problems because we will find a total war, a war that will never end. Yes. So now we are just counting just for independence. So we are begging the ambassador who has been in Cameroon, Mr. Peter, that he should go and try to see with the United Nations and the President Donald Trump so that they should arrange ways to come and grant us our independence, because they know they have read the history, they have all the documents there in the United Nations that we have been an independent state. So they should not behave as if they don't know. They should negotiate and come and make peace so that we can have our independence in a peaceful way, and we become, you know, good friends with the Republic, good friends with all our other African countries, and we start developing our country as a truly democratic country. God bless the whole Amazonians. Please don't forget My trip to Boya is the solution. I'm begging all the Amazonians in France, because you should not sleep. My trip to Boya. Don't also forget that the refugees are there. Try and see what you can do to send for the refugees. Anything that you can send, it doesn't mean how small it is. Try. Don't forget that there's also those who are there in the sale. Try those in France, those in Ireland, those in Belgium, those in Holland, those in Germany, Australia, Dubai, South Africa, you know, America, Argentina, Jakarta, Indonesia, China, Japan, Sri Lanka, everywhere in the world, Canada, please, all the rest of Africa, the world. Think about those and know that our struggle must come to an end with our independence. God bless you people. Thank you.